General Villanueva, may narinig po ba kayong kahit sinong high-ranking army official na di umano sinuhulan ni Go Huaping?
Madam Chair, I don't have any information about the army officer.
And what about General Karamat? May balita po ba kayo? Ano bang balita niyo tungkol sa dating hepe ng CIDG?
I'm not really sure, sir, kung yun ang ma'am, kung yun ang narinig ko. He is part of the information. Hindi ko masyadong sigurado, ma'am. Wala naman kaming formal communication with most of the intelligence officers. One or two lang nagbumanggit sa akin, pero...
Tungkol kay General Karamat?
Yeah, no, ma'am. Partly, but...
Partly kay General Karamat?
Hindi, ma'am. Yung information, hindi... parang may sinabi lang sila sa CIDG, pero walang specific name na General Karamat, ma'am.
So yung unit ng CIDG ang nababanggit ng ilan mga intelligence operatives. And nabanggit nyo rin po kanina yung monthly na payola. What about mga dating government officials o cabinet secretaries? Kasama po ba sila sa usap-usapan sa intelligence community?
No information, ma'am. None, ma'am.
Alright. Salamat, Chair. General. Yes, SP Pro Tempore.
Yung sinasabi nyo monthly payroll, mga police, alam nyo, unfair yata sa police organization o sa Philippine National Police in general. Siguro, pwede nyo nang pangalanan kung sino itong mga police na na under the monthly payroll. Kasi, I think it's unfair for the police organization. Kasi, syempre, we'll cast doubts on them. On all of them.
Yeah. Madam Chair, actually, I don't have the name except there was some rumors in the intelligence community that a former chief PNP, that's only the information.
Former chief PNP?
Yes, sir. We don't have the exact name.
Hindi niya pwede pangalanan?
I don't have the name, sir, kung sino talaga. Basta former chief PNP lang.
Madam, is that the gossip or? Huh? Anyway,
that's why I said, sir, that the intelligence community are still verifying it. They have to confirm it yet. Okay.
Madam Chair, and with the indulgence of our colleagues,
Senator Joel,
in the name of fairness, Madam Chair, we have here with us General Karamat, and I also agree with Senator Jinggoy. Ayaw natin madungisan yung pangalan ng ating kapulisan. Ayaw din nating just draw conclusion right away na merong ganito, merong ganyan. And we have heard a lot of rumors, etc. Pero this time, may mga affidavits, may mga na-interview po tayo na lumalabas yung pangalan ni General Karamat. And yung last hearing, lumabas din po yung pictures, etc. So, in the name of fairness, perhaps, Madam Chair, we can give a time and we let General Karamat also speak and defend himself. And at the same time, perhaps, if he knows anything about all these rumors that even a former PNP chief is also part of this brouhaha, Your Honors. Please.
Senator Joel, may General Karamat, meron ba kayong gustong sabihin sa komiteng ito sa investigasyon namin?
Madam Chairman and honorable members of this committee, good afternoon, sir. Sir, as for the information that there was an involvement of a former chief PNP, I haven't got any information regarding that on that matter, sir, ma'am.
Your Honor, you are a police commander of PNP Northern Luzon. When the time na nagkaroon po ng raid yung PAOK dito sa Zunyuan, is that correct, sir?
No, Mr. Chair, I was
hindi po kayo.
I was in the criminal investigation and director of the CIDG,
Mr. Chair. Pero by that time po, may humingi ba sa inyo ng tulong or you heard about this raid, sir?
Actually, when I was duly designated as the director of the CIDG, we raided Pogo in Banban, the first time that the Pogo in Banban was raided.
Kayo po yung nasa Northern Luzon?
No, no, no,
hindi po,
no Mr. Chair, I was the director, Mr. Chair.
Yeah, so when the time came na yung PAOK TF po ang nag-raid, wala na po kayo?
I was still the director of the CIDG, Mr. Chair.
Yes. Were you informed about it?
No, sir.
Did they ask help from you? Did you give any advice to PAOK?
I was then on leave. That's the reason why maybe I was not informed of the second raid in the Pogo in Banban, Mr.
Kailan Chair. Niyo po nalaman, sir, na ni-raid na?
After I arrived, sir. From vacation, Mr. Chair.
So after you arrived, when was that? A day or two after?
Immediately after my vacation, Mr. Chair.
So when was that, sir? Is that the same day that they raided? Or
I was still on leave when they conducted the raid, Mr. Chair.
Opo, nung dumating na po kayo, mga ilang araw na po yun natapos yung raid?
I think
kahit estimate lang, sir.
3 to 4 days after the raid was conducted, Mr. Chair.
At nagbigay ko kayo ng payo sa kanila because you said from the first raid, kasama ko kayo.
Well, to be honest, Mr. Chair, I was upset why I was not informed.
Okay.
It was an slap on my face as the director of the CIDG. And they used my men in that raid and they didn't bother to inform me. So I was upset. But I understand my men that they are just following orders from the chief PNP. So I helped them in their investigation. But even though, honestly, I was upset and I confronted the chief PNP why he didn't inform me of that raid. So
who was the chief
offered,
PNP?
General Acorda then, Mr. Chair, sir.
You said you were upset. You claimed that it was a slap on your face. Pero nagbigay tulong pa rin po kayo. Is that correct? Anong tulong po yung binigay ninyo?
I directed all my investigators to assist in filing the case against that in that Pogo operation.
Okay. Sir, sabi niyo slap in your face because your men actually, yung mga tao po ninyo, yung kasamang nag-rig. Pero ang pagkakaalam ko po, Madam Chair, ang CIDG NCR po ang tumulong sa PAOK, hindi yung sa regional. Is that correct?
CIDG NCR is still under my command,
yes,
Mr. Chair.
Yes, but
Jeter.
Not from the Central Zone.
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Oh, and this happened under your nose, so hindi nyo po alam ito when it happened?
I don't know the wisdom of the chief PNP and the PAOK why they didn't inform me on during that operation. Maybe because I am on leave, Mr. Chair.
Maybe you're on leave or maybe Your Honor, Madam Chair, it is because meron pong pangamba sa inyo that you are part of this. Is that something that you thought about, sir?
I talk to the then former chief PNP that if he doesn't trust me, he could immediately relieve me from the as director of the CIDG. I confronted the former chief PNP, kung wala ka nang tiwala sa akin, alisin mo na ako.
And when you confronted him, did he mention na kaya hindi ka in-inform is because you might be part of this? Hindi po na sinabi
yan. Ang sabi niya lang, nawala sa isip niya dahil nasa live ka naman. So, hindi ko na alam kung sabi niya, sir.
Sir, ano yung connection po ninyo? Kasi last time pinakita yung picture niyo with JP Samson. Anong connection niyo po sa kanya? Magkaibigan po kayo?
Actually, JP Samson, nung unang tinanong yan sa akin sa Kongreso, hindi ko matandaan yung pangalan. But when the pinakita yung picture sa screen, I remember him. And then, pinakilala lang sa akin as GP Taba or GP Baliwag kasi siya po yung may-ari ng Baliwag Litson. And that was the first time I saw him, Mr. Chair.
So, hindi ho kayo matagal nang magkakilala? Wala kayong pinagsamahan na anumang perhaps business interest or anything, sir?
No, Mr. Chair. That was the first time I saw that guy, Mr. Chair.
Sir, may mga last na lang po, Madam Chair, no? May mga binanggit before na when it comes to issuing a search warrant, merong advice from PAOK, from CIDG, I don't know who it is, advise them not to apply for a search warrant to raid Zone U1, Pogo in Bamban. Are you aware of this, sir?
I do not. I'm not aware of that information, sir.
You will never advise anyone, specifically PAOK, not to apply for a search warrant in Zone U1, Your Honor. Just for the record.
Wala pong ganyan, sir, at hindi ko po under ang PAOK. So, ang director ng CIDG have no power or no reason to dictate.
Yes, that's why my question is, yes, there is no advice whatsoever coming from your
That's correct, end. Mr. Chairman.
Thank you, Madam Chair, and perhaps we'll ask PAOK later on, yes, during my time. Thank you.
Salamat, Senator Joel. Yes, gusto ko lang ipaalala na pagkatapos ng chair, ito po yung flow na susundan natin. So, pagkatapos ko, si SP Pro Tempore, Majority Leader, Senator Sherwin, Senator Joel, and... Okay. Wala na si Sen Minority. Alright. General Karamat, gaano po kayo ka-close kay Mayor Kalugay? At gaano katagal na po kayo magkakilala?
Mayor Dong Kalugay was a former policeman, and
yes,
we were assigned in the same police provincial office in Lingayen, Pangasinan. And hindi pa yan, Mayor, kakilala ko na po, Mr. Chair.
Ganong katagal na po? Ilang taon na?
Mga 10 years, I think, or maybe more, Mr. Chair.
So higit pa po sa isang dekada?
Yes, Mr. Chair.
Alright po. Mayor Kalugay, kayo naman po, anong link nyo kay General Karamat?
Bilang superior ko po, ganun lang po. Dati.
Superior nyo?
Hindi naman po kami nagkasama po sa isang opisina, pero na-assign po ako ng Provincial Police Office po.
Okay. Yung sinabi din nila na PPO Lingayen, Pangasinan.
Tama po, Madam Chair.
Okay po. Magkakilala po ba sina General Karamat at si Go Huaping?
Hindi ko po alam, Madam Chair.
Or naging topic po ba ng pag-uusap nyo ni General Karamat si Go Huaping?
Hindi rin po, Madam Chair.
May chance ba na pinakilala nyo ba silang dalawa sa isa't isa?
Wala pong ganong pinakilala ko po, Madam Chair.
Walang ganon.